This is Keyed In with Max and Brent, unlocking the minds of the industry's top real estate professionals. And now, here are your hosts, Max Rabin and Brent Jackson.
Welcome to the Keyed In podcast. I am Brent Jackson.
I'm Max Rabin.
Hey, Max, how are you doing?
I'm doing fantastic. So this is Thanksgiving week. Am I correct?
This is Thanksgiving week. Changing it up a little bit, just talking between you and myself. Year-to-date recap on the market, the podcast, what we have planned for the Thanksgiving week, all that jazz.
So just these are just the filler cuts. This isn't like the meat of the podcast. Does anyone even care about us anymore?
Not at all. We're not going to have any guests. We're going to have people stop signing off and whatnot.
So, year-to-date, like this is, 2021. Yes. 2020 was an amazing year. I think we both agree on that. 2021 is like a bigger year already, and it's not quite done yet. So I think that a lot of other realtors would agree that this has been quite the market. The intensity has been something else, right? I mean, it's just...
You're absolutely right. So we set our goals. We'll set our 22 goal in December. We did our 21 goal in December of 20, and we are already 20 million over our 21 goal. So we're having the best year we've ever had on our team. I think the firm as well. How is your year going?
Our team is on par with last year. Personally, my business exceeded last year by a long shot. But as a team, we're exactly on par with last year, which was already a huge year. So we have no complaints whatsoever about sales, pace of sales. We're just talking with another guest about what we think the market's going to do in 2022. And I think just there still is putting a lot of pressure on reopening things post-COVID. And I think that especially for us more urban-focused realtors, we're just going to be really busy.
Especially in the condo market. The condo market has been a little softer in COVID. They want like the one bedrooms. You do a lot of one bedrooms. They want a den. They want outdoor space. So I could see the smaller or even the luxury market, you know, bouncing back very strongly in 22.
Well, the anecdotes too, if you read, Wall Street Journal, New York Times, a lot of people who sort of bugged out of cities, Manhattan, Brooklyn, Washington, D.C., pick your city. They were like, well, I don't need to live here. I can live anywhere. I'm on Zoom all the time. They found out that if you living outside of the city requires a lot of maintenance, and some of those towns that are secondary cities or small towns are what they are. They're sleepy small towns. That doesn't mean that they're not great places. But for the urban dweller, I think that there's really no replacement for that. You got to come back. So,
no, and I think rubbing shoulders with your peers goes a long way, because the synergy created on whatever task or platform or initiative you're trying to get in your industry, it's a lot more productive if you're able to be in the same room with all of your peers to, you know, hit certain milestones, achieve certain goals. So I think I read an article in New York Times, I don't know if it was this week or last week, but I think Google is now shifting, where before they were going to be out all of 22, but now they're seeing they want all of their engineers back in-house so they can do exactly what I just described.
Yeah. Yep. I agree. I think it's going to happen.
Max, what's your take on the, we've been doing this now, not on my business plan in 2020 was to start a podcast. So this kind of came out of nowhere. What's your take on the show?
I've been really happy with the show for a lot of different reasons. Obviously, really happy to work with you. I think we share some mutual respect for each other. We share some mutual respect for each other. We're definitely solid peers out here in the market. So it's great to get to work with you and talk to you on a regular basis. But yeah, being with all of these fantastic guests in our market, and you know, talking to people in our company, outside of our company. We've had some guests where I get to experience their energy and see what how they connect with their clients. Yes, we all do the same job sort of technically at the base of it, but everyone has a different approach. Everyone is a different feel. And just being able to have this platform to ask them about it and get the response, like an open response, that's fantastic.
I couldn't agree more. I mean, it's a pleasure working side with you, and I think you're a great host. I mean, you're very unlike me, sometimes I speak too fast, too low, too soft. You're very articulate with all of your questions and on point with, you know, 99% of them. So it's been a pleasure. And to your point, it's rewarding to sit back, and some of these are our competitors and we're going in head to head on listing presentations, and right. just to hear their, you know, rags to riches story, how they're you know, successful and what they're doing different than what we're doing. I'm always taking notes, you know, thinking about how we can better our business by listening to the Me guests too. That we have on the show.
Me too. And, you know, I think that, I don't know, recently I was thinking about working with your competition or having these conversations with your competition in an open forum like this. It's like, well, we have egos too, right? But there's first of all, there's a lot of business to go around, and we have to all work together. There's never going to be one singular realtor that everyone is going to go to. There's always going to be competition in the marketplace, and that's what being a business person is all about. So I enjoy the open forum and having it be just a discussion in this form of media. It's brilliant. And then when we switch it off, we're back in the trenches and competing for those listings, right?
Exactly. Yeah. I'm hoping that the listeners out there, whether it's new agents, veteran agents, or agents that are just right in the middle of their career, they're getting something from it. And if they're not, we're gladly to take on suggestions, right? Like, do we need different guests? Do you want to be a guest? You know, you can reach out to Max. Who do you want to hear from? It's like, if you have guest suggestions, reach out to us. If you want to be on the show, I've had probably 7 or 8 people reach out to me who want to be on the show.
Totally. So what do you want to hear? Who do you want to hear? Just let us know. And we're wide open on that and happy to do it.
Yeah. And to give some of our listeners a little bit of background here, we're going to go until 12/20. That's the last Monday for our first season here. We're going to take a little bit of a break, start recording the 1st of January, and then January 24th will be dropping season 2 or the next phase of our show. So I think we've already got 3 or 4 lined up for the 1st of January. So if people want to be on the show, just reach out to us, subscribe, tell your friends, whatnot. I think we're approaching, I know we've got thousands of listeners. I think we're almost to the brink of that 10,000 mark, which would be great for us to get to.
Look, some people don't listen to podcasts very often. They're like, oh, I don't have time to listen to like 3 hours of a podcast or an hour. You don't, just listen for 5 minutes. Just maybe you'll pick up something that you've never heard before. Maybe you'll hear something inspiring. You never know. Just 5 minutes. Then leave it on for 10 minutes and maybe 15. See? Yep. And it just adds up. Put it on, keeps adding us on up. Double speed. Put us on double speed. It's so easy.
Yeah, that's how I listen to all my stuff. It's like I can turn an hour podcast down into like 35 or 40 minutes. So I'm good to go that way. So as you mentioned at the top of the show here, it's a holiday week. It's Thanksgiving. What do you have planned?
I've got family coming to town. My father and his wife are coming. They're flying in from Poland, but LA first, then coming here. And then got the whole family for Thanksgiving at the house, the old school way. We're going to smoke a turkey on the Traeger grill, and my girlfriend she's a great chef. Like she knows what she's doing in the kitchen. So this is her Super Bowl. This is it. And I'm just letting her, she can do, I'll handle the dealing with the turkey outside, but she's going to be in the kitchen just crushing it. So
yeah. Very nice. I think for us, little guy gets out of school on Tuesday. Then we have tennis camp Tuesday evening. We'll go to West Virginia Tuesday night or Wednesday morning. This will be our last Thanksgiving at the Greenbrier. You know, knock on wood, I'm probably going to jinx everything now, but we sold that home and it closes middle of January. Okay. So we're going to spend Thanksgiving and Christmas there. This Thanksgiving Thursday, we have reservations down at the club for 11 of us. So we'll all go down there, eat a good healthy meal. It's buffet style. We don't have to worry about cleaning, cooking, all like that jazz. You just pick up, go back to the house.
My existence is going to be a lot of cleaning. I am aware of this.
Half the battle. Yeah.
We did restaurant Thanksgiving for a couple of years, and it was nice. When you have a bunch of guests like this coming from out of town, you got to go
old school. You got to do it right.
Yeah.
So, thankful for family, team, my health, the firm.
All the above.
Thankful for all the listeners, our clients. Thank you guys for tuning in. Hope you guys like the show and keep subscribing. Max, anything else to add there?
Yeah, man. Just super thankful that we have our health, and I love my family very much, and just appreciate that we can do all this. It's amazing stuff. Like, we're very blessed, man. Very blessed.
Happy Thanksgiving, buddy.
All right. Likewise. Happy Thanksgiving.
Thanks for listening to Keyed In with your hosts, Max and Brent, unlocking the minds of the industry's top real estate professionals. For more information on selling your home, find us online at keyedinpodcast.com. Remember to subscribe to Keyed In on Apple Podcasts or wherever you like to listen to podcasts. Follow us on Instagram at Keyed In Podcast, at Raven Max, and at Brent E. Jackson. And follow Max on TikTok @MaxwellRaben_properties.